Now we are storing decimal number as a long integer. Okay, so it is a number. Please remember, it is a number. Right. I'll come back to you, Abhinosh. Okay. Once let us execute this. I'll clear your doubt afterwards. Okay. Right. So yes. Okay. Just see here. So here we are taking this variable dn, decimal number, we are storing as a long integer. Okay, so which is nothing but a number. Please remember. Okay, so this is decimal number. Okay, so then you need to store the equivalent hexadecimal number as a string. We need to store because the equivalent hexadecimal number may contain characters. No, so that's why it has to be stored as a string. It has to be stored as a string. You cannot use though we mention is a single else if loop, its respective remainder is taken. Like if the number is in 12, then also, yeah, the same logic applies. The same logic applies. Okay. Once we are done with this, now we can apply it for 12, 16, 17, any logic we can apply this. Okay. Right. Just let me complete this example. Then we'll take all the doubts. Then your character array. Now you are storing your equivalent hexadecimal number as a string here. Okay. So this you just observe here. Okay. So assume this is our hexadecimal number, HN. Okay. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And our variable I initially contains a 0. Okay. Right. So you have one more variable called as a reminder. Okay. So here I am taking that variable reminder so that you will come to know every time what is coming inside. Okay. So first I take a number example. I take the number example. Then afterwards I'll take alphanumeric example. Okay. So what happens? We'll take afterwards. Now first what we do, 86 we'll take. Okay. So 86 example we'll take, whether we get 56 or not, we have to see. Okay, but if we print, we are printing in a reverse order, I think. Okay, so that will convert afterwards, at least. We are storing the digits in hexadecimal array correctly or not, we'll see here. Okay, right. So enter a decimal number. Enter a decimal number. Okay, so what you entered? You entered the number 86. Okay, so your DN contains 86. Okay, now while DN is 86, while DN means 86, true? Yes, this is true. Okay, so just see here, remainder is called DN mod 16, 86 mod 16. What is the remainder we got there? What is the remainder we got? 86. 86 mod 16 means remainder 6 we got. Okay, so now your this remainder variable contains a 6. Okay, right? Now you see here, if remainder is greater than or equal to 0 and remainder is less than or equal to 9. Okay, so here we should not use this single quotes because remainder we are getting the number itself 0 to 9. Okay, so that's why you should not use these single quotes here. Okay, if your remainder is between 0 to 9, is it between 0 to 9? Yes. Okay, so since it is between 0 to 9, now what we need to do, just see here. Okay, so HN of I, what is HN of I here? HN of I is, I value is 0, HN of 0, I am going to store here. Remainder plus 48, remainder plus 48, remainder is what? Remainder is 6, okay, so 6 plus 48, if I store 6 plus 48, what I'll get here, 8 plus 6 is 4, and this is 54. Okay, so then I'm getting the number 54 here. Okay, so when I store that number inside a character array, that will be stored as equivalent, 54 equivalent, decimal equivalent ASCII character it stores. Okay, so what is equivalent ASCII character for 54 decimal number? Just see here, 54 decimal number. Okay, so what is its equivalent ASCII character? This is ASCII character 6, see here. Okay, so 6 is the character. That means it will be stored internally as a character 6, because in string you cannot store a number. Okay, so this will be stored as a character 6. Okay, so then this entire else is not executed. This entire else is not executed. Okay, then after coming out from this if statement, I think you need to reduce our decimal number. No, that statement we missed here. Okay, so here what we need to do, you need to say decimal number slash is equals to, with which number? 16. Decimal number is called decimal number by 16, you have to say. Okay, so when you say decimal number is called decimal number by 16, okay, so what is that quotient you will get? Quotient you will get as a, the quotient you will get 5 here. Okay, so 5 is the quotient you will get. Yes or no? This 5 quotient you will get. Now reminder, we obtained 6 and we stored as a character 6. Now we hope you got why we added 48 here. Why we added 48? Because 48 is nothing but ASCII value of 0. ASCII value of 0 plus 6 if you add, then that will become the character 6. That will become the character 6. Is it okay? Right. So then dn slash is equal to 16 means dn will become 5 now. Okay. So end of the loop reaches, again it goes up. Again it goes up. Now it checks while dn, while 5 means true. Okay. Remainder is equal to dn mod 16. Okay. So what happens? Dn mod 16 means when you divide 5 with 16, you will get the remainder as 5. Okay. So remainder is equal to 5. So this time remainder value will be 5. Okay, so here you will have the remainder as a 5. Now 5 will be present in the remainder. Okay, then it checks remainder greater than or equal to 0 and between 0 to 9. Yes, then HN of I plus plus here, after storing this remainder plus 48 character into, then I value will increment. This is because this is post increment. No, after performing this assignment, I value will increment and I value will become 1 now. I value will become 1 now. Okay, so now when this condition is true, again HN of I value is 1 now. HN of 1 is equal to what happens? Remainder plus 48. Remainder is how much? 5. 5 plus 48 is nothing but the character 5. Internally it will be stored as character 5. 48 plus 5 means 53. Okay, yes or no? So 53 is nothing but the character 5. It will be stored as character 5 internally. Okay, so this entire else block is skipped here. Entire else block is skipped here. Then dn is called dn slash 16 means next time remainder what you will get? 0 you will get. Then while dn false, condition becomes false. Dn is 0, no? Condition becomes false. Okay, now see here. This is our hexadecimal array. This is our hexadecimal array. Okay, so you have to print the actually array in a reverse order. Yes or no? 86, where is our 86? See, 86 equivalent hexadecimal number is 56. If you print directly by using HN 65, it will be printed as a 65. Okay, so first let us execute this. Then after I'll make correction so that the array will be printed in a reverse direction. Okay, is it okay now? Then we'll take up a alphanumeric type example. Yeah, so quickly. Control C, okay, right. Now I'll go to online C compiler here. I'm just copy pasting this here. Okay, right. So let me directly run the code. Okay, if any errors, we'll Yeah, enter a decimal number. Okay, so 86, our example, no? 86. What is expected output here? 65, because we are printing the array as it is. Okay, so 65. Yeah, 65, after what happened? Some extra symbols it has printed. Okay, so this also gives a wrong output. Okay, because your output is not matching with the expected output. You should not print any extra character, I said. You should not print any extra character, I told. Okay, so to why it is, because we have not ended the character array. We have not ended the character array. Okay, so what we need to do, just think of this one. Okay, so where is our diagram? Now, if you see 6, 5 we have stored, and already these contains garbage values. These contains garbage values. So what you need to do when you store into a character array, individual characters, you need to store /0 explicitly. You have to store /0 explicitly. If you store /0 explicitly, then only 65 will be printed. Okay, those extra characters will not be printed. Okay, so that you have to do in your program. So for that purpose, what you need to do after coming out from the loop, anyhow, I++ will be happening, no? I value will go to the next place. Okay, so here, you have to say hn of i is equals to /0. Hn of I is equal to /0, because it is a character, you have to enclose it in a single quotes. Okay, so when you add this statement, then extra characters are not printed here. Just see here. Okay, so I will show this. I'm adding this here. Now, extra characters are eliminated. After 65, you have seen some extra characters, no? That can be eliminated here. Just see here. Yo, 686. Now, see, 65 printed. Okay, so that means it reads your array character by character. 6, it prints. 5, it prints. Then whenever it encounters /0, immediately it stops. Otherwise, if there is no /0, it goes on reading your array. That means our garbage values it reads, and somewhere it stops whenever it encounters some /0 kind of thing. That's why you are seeing some unnecessary characters printed on the screen. Okay. Abhiram, just let me complete this. Afterwards, I'll take your doubt. Okay. So still, we are not printing the number in correct order. We have to print the array in reverse order. Okay. So that means you need to change the logic here. Okay. So you need to change the logic here. Okay. So how you can print the array in reverse order? The one thing is you can just declare a variable, yes, which stores length of the array. You do not know how many characters are there. Okay. So you just define string length. Okay. So otherwise here you say len length is equal to string length of hn, you can say string length of our array. What is our array name? Hn is our array name. No. So it gives string length. Okay. So what is the string length in our case? In this case, what is the string length you will get? 65 means number of characters present in this array. Okay, 6, 5, only 2 characters are there. Okay, so it gives length is equal to 2. But where is the first last character? Last character is present in position index 1. So you have to start printing from index 1 onwards. If you start printing from 2 onwards, then this /0, that means some unnecessary character will be printed. So you should be very careful there. Okay, so then immediately what you need to do is after this, you just say length minus minus, length minus minus. Okay, so then it comes to before character, /0 before character it reaches. Okay, so now using a for loop, you can print character by character until you reach. Okay, so here heading, you can leave this as it is. Just say equivalent number is equals to, close this here. Okay, so now use the for loop and go to next page so that it can be visible to you. Okay, so I am just taking this into new page. Right. So here what you need to do, just heading you print equivalent hexadecimal number. Okay, so then by using some for loop, character by character. Okay, so for say int k is equals to what? K is equal to what? Length. For int k is equals to length, that means last character. I'm start printing from last character onwards. So k greater than or equals to zero. Until you reach zero, then say k minus minus. K minus minus. Okay, so then say printf percentage c. Okay, comma. What is our array name? Hn of k, you can say. Hn of k. That's it. Okay, so then this prints your hexadecimal, equivalent hexadecimal number in correct order. Okay, right? So I add this code into our online compiler. Okay, so after this, I need to remove this everything, no? Yeah, this line I'll remove and I paste that code here. Okay, so I found the length of our hexadecimal array. Then immediately I moved to last character. Then I'm printing from last character to first character onwards. Okay, so now let us run the code. String length function we included, no? Anyhow, it is asking to enter a number. 86 I entered. Okay, so now you can see equivalent decimal number is equal to 56. Let me just add string dot h here. Hash include string dot h. Okay, so if you are getting some warnings, you can just if you know how to eliminate that warning, it's okay. Otherwise, don't waste your time thinking of about that warning and you proceed with your execution in TCS Ninja exam. Okay, right. So, right now, if we run this code, now you can see entry a decimal number 86, equivalent number is 56. We have taken one another numerical example, no? So whether it prints that correctly or not. What is the first number? 72. We entered 48. We should get. Okay, so let us just quickly check out that. 72 equivalent decimal hexadecimal number is equal to 48. We got. Is it okay? Okay. So what I am trying to do here, hope you got. Okay. So I am trying to print the array in reverse order. Okay. When I found a string length, it gives 2 here. Okay. So length minus minus means it comes to this last character. Okay. So from last character onwards and up to 0th position, I am printing the numbers in reverse order. Then it gives the equivalent hexadecimal number. Okay, right? So now I'll take up your doubts. Okay, so Abhiram, you can unmute and just what is your doubt? You can just speak out. Let me just. Is it possible to unmute yourself or shall I allow you? Yeah, you can unmute.
Sir, am I audible, sir?
Louder, bit louder.
Sir, is it okay now?
One second.
Sir, is it okay now?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, sir. Sir, I have two questions, sir. First one is, are we like, after converting to hexadecimal, we must also have that A or C or D representations also, no, sir.
Yes, yes.
Not the value as 65 or something. And second one is, sir, even though we mention the separate else if loops, instead of that, if you write as remainder greater than or equal to 10, and remainder or remainder less than or equal to 15, HN of plus plus is equals to remainder plus 55, both like both these my condition and this condition both will be same, sir.
You try if your code is working, just share in the group. Okay, I will look into that code. Okay, whatever idea you got, Abhinav, you try to implement, you check out just. Okay, so if it is working, then you share that code. I look into that code. Okay, here the point is between 10 to 15, okay, 10, 11, 12, remainder, which remainder you got, you do not know, your program do not know whether remainder is 10, whether remainder is 12, whether remainder is 13 or 14. Based on the remainder, it has to store the equivalent character. It has to store the equivalent character in the hexadecimal array. Yes or no? Okay, so if you write a single range, then how you can convert the number into that range? Okay, you try. That is also possible. I don't say that it is not possible. Okay, so you can also use, because it is only one character you will get. No need of writing any for loop there. Every time it divides, we'll get a single remainder, no? So with one single loop, we are working out. Again, in while loop, you are using a for loop. In while loop, you are using a for loop. Okay, so just think of. Okay, you work out on paper, you will come to know what is the problem in that. Okay, Abhiram? Right. Now, let us just take an alphanumeric character hexadecimal representation from decimal. Decimal to hexadecimal representation. Okay, so 76. How we'll get 76? In our program, we'll just see here. Okay, so that you will come to know. Just the same 76 example I'll take. Okay, so I show the hexadecimal array representation. Now, how it will be stored, just see here. This is our HN array. Okay, so this is 0, 1, and 2, right? So enter a decimal number. Okay, so how much we entered? 76, this one. Okay, so just you think of this 76, I entered. Okay, so while 76, true, remainder is equal to 76 mod 16. Remainder is equal to 76 mod 16. Okay, so 76, if you divide with 16, what you will get, just think of. Okay, 16 fours are 64. Sorry. Sixteen fours are 64. Okay, so then the remainder is 12. Then the remainder you are getting as a 12. Okay, now see here, the remainder is 12. Then in remainder we got a 12. Okay, so this is our variable remainder. 12 we got. Now it checks if remainder is between 0 to 9. No, 0 to 9. No. Then it comes to this else. If remainder is equal to 10, no. Then it comes to next else. If remainder is equal to 11, no. It comes to next else. If remainder is equal to 12, yes. Then it comes here. HN of I is equal to remainder plus 55. Remainder plus 55. Okay. So what happens here? Remainder plus 55 means 12 plus 55. Okay. So 12 plus 55 is nothing but 77. 12 plus 55 is nothing but 77. So what is the equivalent decimal hexadecimal number for 12? Equivalent hexadecimal number for 12, that is nothing but C. Yes or no? Okay. So this must be stored as a C. Okay. So what number we got when you add 55? 77 we got. Okay. So just think of here. So what is the ASCII value of 77? ASCII chart. Okay, so 77. Sorry, 67. 67. It is coming to 67. Okay, so 67 ASCII chart is C. Just see here. 67 decimal value, and in character it is represented as a C. In character it is represented as a C. Okay, so here we are getting this as a 67. Okay, now I am trying to store 60, the number 67 into a character array. Okay, so please remember, this character internally will be stored as a ASCII number, integer number. Okay, so it is internally stored as 67. Okay, so when you store 67 into character, it will be stored as capital C. It will be stored as capital C. And capital C, if you try to print using percentage D, it will be printed as 67. This is possible because character is integer only, integer is character only. Please remember. Okay, so then this will be stored as a capital C. This will be stored as a capital C. Then remaining else part is not executed. Then dn slash is equal to 16. When you say dn slash is equal to 16, what is the quotient you will get here? 4 is the quotient you will get. 4 is the quotient you will get. Okay, so then end of the loop reaches boo. While 4, true, remainder is equal to, remainder this time what you will get? 4 you will get, remainder. Okay, so 0 to 9, yes. Then 4 plus 48, okay? So 4 plus 48 is 52. Okay, so 52 bits, it is nothing but the character 4. Okay, so character 4, it will be stored as a character 4. So it will be stored as character 4. This is also a character. Okay, so then dn slash 16 is equal to 0 you will get, and while 0 means false, comes out from the loop. While 0 means false, comes out from the loop. Now you can say hn of I is equal to slash 0. So here already after storing this 4, I plus plus is happening. So that's why I will come to next position anyhow. So directly I am storing hn of I is equal to slash 0. So slash 0 will be stored here. Okay, so then again, we are trying to find out the length of the string. Where is that? Yes. Just let me copy this. Okay, so then we are finding string length. String length reduces as to length minus minus means we'll come to position 1. Then when you print the number from position 1 to 0, it prints the equivalent hexadecimal number. Okay, so this is the logic we are implemented to convert decimal to hexadecimal number. Okay, so now the same number we enter as input 76. Okay, so 76 we enter as input. We'll let us run the code. Enter a number, 76 I enter. Okay, so CN, equivalent hexadecimal number is equal to 4C. Now you can test this for any number. Okay, so let us just quickly enter some number. Okay, so 10980 if I enter. What is that I will get? 2AE4 I am getting. Okay, so otherwise I enter some 3-digit number. Okay, so you can check out 234 if I enter. Okay, EA I am getting. Okay, so E is nothing but 14. A is nothing but 10. A is nothing but 10. Okay, so you remember these two values. Is it clear? Shall we proceed with the next program, reverse conversion, hexadecimal number to decimal conversion. Now, I think someone asked why we are adding 55 here. Okay, so why we are adding 55 here? Because 10 should be represented as a capital A. 10 should be represented as a capital A. Okay, capital A ASCII value is 65. Okay, so 10 plus 55, if you add, then its value will become 65, nothing but it is capital A. Okay, if you remember ASCII values of these three, capital A, small a, and zero. Capital A ASCII value is 65, small a ASCII value is 97, and zero ASCII value is 48. Zero ASCII value is 48. Every day you need to recollect this. Zero ASCII value is 48. Okay, you write it on a paper and stick to the back side of a door. Okay, so whenever you are brushing, just go there and look at those values.